YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, it's your boy. And this is probably the saddest rant I've ever done and I'm going to make it a rant because I'm pissed off and I'm hurt. And it's just, this is a sad time for on Monday, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, it's your boy, Mr. 2000. What's good, man? I come to you today with a very sad rant. I'm going to just get into it. In Chicago, on Monday, a six-month-old baby was gunned down while her father was changing her diaper in the van. This beautiful little girl, 6 months old. Do you know, first of all, do you know what a baby does at 6 months old? They're not making executive decisions or anything. They're just learning their hand movements. They're smiling, big eye babies, beautiful, just kind of learning the world, you know? Getting used to the people that are around them, these strange people that are taking care of her. You know, and I'm looking at pictures of the little girl, and she's very beautiful. I mean, it wasn't like, you know, there was a problem, and she looks like she was happy, and the family was happy to have her, you know? And she was killed by these bitch-ass cowards. Whatever happened to, just respect to the game, you know. No innocent women and children, you know. I respect the game. I respect what we do as far as, you know what I'm saying, hustling and stuff, you know what I'm saying. I know sometimes you gotta, you know, you do what you gotta do, you know, to handle your business, and I definitely respect the streets that in that form. But not a baby, man. Not a baby. Not a innocent six-month-old baby, you know? She didn't do anything to deserve it. She was just being a baby. And some cowards, you know? And for the last 6 months, I've had kind of a little issue with the city of Chicago myself, because they got a lot of rules, the police does, you know, where they're saying that they don't respond to certain things that are going on in the hood. And, you know, people, you know, basically, it's almost like someone can get shot and they wouldn't give a fuck. And that's not, I wish the police here would do some shit like that, because I'll be the first one on a picket line, like, fuck y'all. You know what I'm saying? Her family didn't deserve this, you know? You know, niggas like that, cats who, if, you know, cause a man or a woman that would kill a six-month-old baby with no remorse, that's the type of motherfuckers that need to be locked up, electric chair, lethal injection, stone, firing squad, them the motherfuckers that need that capital punishment. You know what I mean? I mean, killing, murdering is wrong. Any form of murder is wrong. You know what I'm saying? But in this case, I'm with it, man, because I have two girls. And I also had a son. A lot of people don't know. I had a son that he was born prematurely. And that was a medical condition that his mother couldn't help. And I held him in my arms and I just cried, man. there was nothing I could do because, you know how it feels to be a parent that can't help your child? You know, when you can't feed your child, it hurts. When you can't clothe your child, it hurts. When your child tells you they want things and you can't buy them for them, that shit hurts. You know, let alone somebody comes along and harms your child and you can't do nothing about it. The van was just shot the fuck up. I'm looking at pictures of the van. I'm looking at all these people around hurt because of this incident. Because now these parents who had high hopes, a man who, and people are talking shit about the father. Oh, he has an extensive criminal background. I'm looking at pictures of this man. I know pictures can't define who a person is. It just kind of tells the story of the moment. But he looks like a man who loved his child. A man who took care of his child. And if he, like me, when I watched my daughter and she, you know, when she was a baby, my youngest daughter, when she, you know, would go in the bathroom herself and we were out in public, I didn't use the public restrooms. I took her out to the car and changed her. You know what I'm saying? That's just how I am. So it sounded like he was a cool father. You know, I mean, I don't know him personally. I don't know the mother personally. You know what I'm saying? Despite his criminal background, he didn't pull the trigger. Some old coward ass motherfuckers did. So please don't blame this man. You know what I'm saying? He lost his daughter too. He lost a child. So if you're not the mother or even the grandparents, I'll give the grandparents that kind of credit. You don't have the right to say shit because the mother and the father are already suffering up without having to hear motherfuckers running their mouth. You know what I'm saying? And he was shot too. And I'm sure he would have gave his life for his child. He said right here, he tried to get to her. He tried to get to her, but it was too late. You know what I'm saying? You get shot. I mean, the bullets fly fast, motherfucker, man. We're not Neo. This ain't the Matrix. You know? Like I said, don't put the blame on the father, man. He looked like he really loved that little girl. And it's enough. It's enough. It's time for us to do something about this. Please. I ask that if the president is listening to this, or anybody important, man, if now was the time for Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson and all them old so-called civil rights motherfuckers to get off their ass and do something, now's the time. Now's the time. Flex your muscle. This is the time we need y'all. Not when it's good and convenient for your image. Now's the time. Y'all supposed to be so hardcore, and we supposed to like look at y'all and be like, oh man, these are the people that we look up to, you know, these leaders. Now's the time for Oprah Winfrey to flex her muscle. Now's the time for Tyler Perry to flex his muscle. Now is the time. All these cats in Chicago, these stars and these so-called philanthropists and shit, now is the time for us to flex our muscle. I can't do it. I make $10 an hour. You know what I'm saying? I'm paying on this camera now, still as we speak. But all I can do is voice my opinion and Twitter it. You know what I'm saying? It's time. It is time. How many six-month-old babies have to die before we realize that that's enough? How many have to die? How many young teenage girls have to die? Oh, yes, I'm going to bring that up, too. Little girls who perform for the president and weeks after, not even a month after, gunned down. The city of Chicago has a problem. They have a problem. Let's call, you know, and if the police can't handle it, let's call in the National Guard. That's what, ain't that what they for? State of emergency? They need to call a state of emergency. They need to go into these inner cities. They need to get these niggas. Get them. Take them out. You don't have no feelings for these babies? Fine, nigga. Fuck you. We don't got no feelings either. Kill them. I don't care. They got to go. You know what I'm saying? Chief Keef running around, parading around, dancing around, talking about that's the shit I don't like with his hair moving and shit. And, you know, like, this shit's cool, man. I don't give a fuck. Whatever. I've never seen no shit like this, man. I know babies and kids have died before in other cities, but I've never seen no shit like this where people are getting murdered back to back and ain't nobody doing nothing about it. Ain't no task force. Ain't no plan of action. Just, oh well. And y'all wonder why we carry guns and we're quick to take the law in our own hands, because honestly, if that had been my baby, I'm not even a hardcore nigga like that. But if that was my baby and she was murdered, y'all might as well buy me a casket, because I'm going to look for them niggas. I'm going to look for them niggas. I'm shooting them all in the head. I want them to feel me. This ain't about money, nigga. This ain't about drugs, turf. You killed my child, nigga. You got to go. My heart goes out to the family, to the mother and the father, the grandparents, and everyone who was important in that baby's life. To all the people who are supporting the family, that's your wonderful people. To any city officials or anybody, let's help this family, man. Let's help them. Let's help them. You know, all we can do is help them. Excuse my language, because I didn't want to cuss on this. But it's enough, man. Enough is enough. It's time, man. It's time for us to come together, man. And I'm not even going down Chicago like that. Don't get me wrong. I mean, Chicago is a wonderful city. My family, my grandmother actually lived there for a while. Aunties and uncles were born there. We got history in Chicago. I've never been, well, I've been there twice, been through there twice, but my friends, I have friends who I went to college with who love their city. I also have friends who told me stories about how bad it is in Chicago. That's nothing to be proud of, man. So, it's time to wake up, man. I'm just a boy from Kansas, man. Paying my respects to this family. Ain't no more to it. Ain't no punchline. My Lord.
old.